Hey guys, it's your boy Cobras, and welcome to my brand new FIFA 17 secondary career mode with Leo. Yes, I am in League of once again. Going full circle while coming back to the league. Oh, which of course is where my secondary career mode ended. And after my Marseille career mode. Last FIFA. So, the league has returned earlier this time. In being the second league chosen. And the team that was chosen from all 20 randomly was Leo. Now, Leo, I've been doing badly in real life. Now, last time I checked, they were just outside the relegation zone. So, yeah, not good season so far for Leo. Put me at the helm. They have absolutely nothing to worry about. So let's get into the first game against Mentz. And let's take down Ligue 1.
Alan Smith is with me. I'm Martin Tyler. Delighted to have your company for this match today. Mets in action today against Lille.
Well, you want width and you want quality.
You can see I've Brian Colabas from.
I think so. And the one player that would be pleased to see
from, Watford, because I got a really good offer for the left back who Lille start with. An offer that I considered a really good one, so I took it. And I decided, you know what? Since he left, I needed a new left back, so I decided I'll bring in Colabas. Yes. And so I was looking for a left back with a really good Mason. I don't know why, but Colabas just stood out to me. He's not the only David in the team. The player on the ball right now is.
Players. Jan Schuster making his debut.
Completely butchering his name. Hang on, I'll you can see it. There he is. He's a 24-year-old Colombian left winger who I signed from, I think it was Club Bruges. I know he came from the Belgian league. I'm like 95% sure it was Club Bruges. It could have been somebody else, but that's who I think it was. So, complete overhaul in the left-hand side of the defense. That the team is relatively as.
Well,
it's made up of players who are at the club in real life. So those are the only two changes.
Obadi. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Here comes the challenge. The referee had a good look at that, decided it's just a throw after the tackle. Sebastian Corchia. There goes the cross.
The ball in. Oh, the block. Here is Colabas.
Looking good, this move. Got past his man here. And in goes the cross.
Good crossing from the Colombian.
It's
And out for a throw.
It was a good cross until it found absolutely no one. Such a petty way to determine what's a good cross and what's a bad cross. That's simply where it went to one of your players or not.
Yeah, he's better to be nervous.
The peripheral goal! Oh, first official goal this career mode scored in the 21st minute. Hit the striker.
What a finish this was. Really did put his boot through it to find the left hand side.
And we are up and running. And probably said his name wrong, but it's what it looks like it says. There's probably some certain way of pronouncing his name. Especially because there's a thing over his first E.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
I'd say it was a thought out, but the French probably call it something else.
Michivac.
Although, first name, not too difficult, Nicholas. Same as Anepka's first name.
This is an exercise in patience as they try to get an opening.
Is Nicholas a popular first name in France or something? And if I have any French viewers, let me know. Oh.
And back it goes to the keeper. Just working away to try and find an opening.
All about swoops it in. No one wants to get to it. And it's gone for a goal kick off the corner flag.
There's good progress with this attack. Tackle here. Marco Bascha.
Approval.
This could be a chance. Strong tackle. And one that's
he went to the corner. See what I can do from the corner. Prove it. Lopez whips it in. Bassa!
Terrific header. I'm lucky it's just off target.
They generated some power on it, and the keeper wasn't getting there.
And he's another one whose name I'm probably... whose name looks easy enough to pronounce, but... with the thing over here, the S. That looks like an arrow to say the S was inserted in because they completely forgot about it.
Good anticipation by the opposing player there to read the direction of the throw. Well, the action is going to continue here. We've got 4 minutes of added time.
So that's why it's there. Although saying that probably means something. But it looks like it said Basta. So that's probably what I'm going to stick to calling him.
Short passes, they're keeping the ball.
Four cross, and that is the end of the first half.
So it's the big day for the manager.
Not overly exciting first half, but it's something. You can see some other matches are going on. Dijon Fico, and that's probably just football club organization is. Well, I'm guessing O stands for? I don't know. Anguera is on the second game against Montpellier, have it as well. And CN are being Laurent. Dijon are being Neres.
It's a tactical substitution for the losing team here.
Mins are making a substitution. Let's see what the difference makes.
Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it.
Good take. Is the player going on?
The opposition have a chance.
Privilege.
Doing well to keep the ball.
I'll take this throw.
Just a quick note for your dog.
Oh, it does not get easier from Mets. They're going to the Parc des Princes to take on the champions. And if I'm not mistaken, they just made another substitution. Yeah, in fact they did. Oh! Just after they made that substitution, I almost go 2-0 up. So not the position you want a central or midfielder in. And you want your striker to be on the end of that. If not a good attacking midfielder, but not a central midfielder. Unless it's the central attacking midfielder. You know what I mean? The criminal is offside and he was offside. And yes, I don't want to hear comments about the manager being bald, that's an accident. I accidentally went forward without changing the avatar to the one I'm going with in all our career modes. Just imagine I went bald from all the stress in Japan. The league making no goddamn sense.
Let's put you in the picture regarding Paul Pogba and his deal done now. It's confirmed. He has moved to Manchester United.
Yeah, and I think that's a really good sign. And the fans are excited. Maybe excited by the £85 million figure that they're reading about too.
Lille have possession here.
Incredible.
Working hard just to see maybe a sight of goal. It's a very good effort to stop that cross.
Again, I'll have to learn how to say my player's name. I can't just go quiet whenever he's on the ball and just...
Now they've got a chance in this...
Hope the commentators are saying whatever his name is.
Good challenge here.
I may have to go calling him by his first name and pull back. Chances are I'll just look it up after this episode is over. To be honest, I probably should have done that before the episode started, but hey, what can you do?
With some danger.
Come on, whip it in. Yes! No! You son of a whore.
The away side have some more action to come. This is it. And this is their fixture.
I was looking ahead to my next fixture. I have absolutely no idea who's Chris that is.
And here's the cross.
I don't recognize it from last FIFA, so they must be a promoted team.
By the defender. Has gone out for a goal kick.
Yeah.
Top class save.
Cross. Say that's what it was. Didn't bother the keeper.
Turn over to the opposition because of that poor touch. Tackle here. Good position. They've worked this attack very well. Into a quite a dangerous position now. Defender to it first. Keep an eye on the watch, because we haven't got that long to go. And the team know that. They can't get too desperate, though. They need to keep some sort of poise about their play.
Yeah, my last step down the pitch.
Forward yet, but we're approaching that moment.
Oh, the defender, he had to get rid of it. Because my player was right there, waiting for the opportunity to present itself, and it almost did. Oh, but there's an opportunity that presents itself. Lopez gets the second to wrap up all 3 points. And what a start to the season.
To emphasize the gulf between
good control from the midfielder. He puts it on a play from Ex Lopez. And my avatar, or despite having lost all his hair, is going. Oh, sorry, it's Marcus Lopez. Wait, is it? Is this a different Lopez? This one, his first name is Max. Am I thinking of somebody else? Max Mulcair. Am I thinking of somebody else? No, I'm confused. I could have sworn his first name was Max.
Dijon 2, nil.
Huh.
Saint-Étienne 2.
Oh, absolutely piss off. Off EA. Just piss off.
Hull 1, Lorient 0.
That doesn't say his first name. Jose. I'm gonna have to call him Jose for the remainder of this episode. Just until I learn how to pronounce his surname. Which will not be in this episode. Nowhere? What the hell?
Oh.
Well, thank you for that. Fucking. That's the most random. Oh, fucking. I don't like it here anymore. Alright, I guess. Well, Chelsea and Arsenal, you timed these offers very well. Oh, very inconveniently, actually. Wait, is he handing a transfer request because they've offered for him, and he knows that? I'm massively confused. Look, they're not going to get you unless they pay you the full amount. 26.1 for both teams. At least he's not going to a rival. Choose wisely, mate, because either way, you're going to either be behind Thibaut Courtois, or fucking either Perisic, or, bizarrely, maybe Manuel Neuer. So, yeah, have fun with that. I have no idea what to do now. I need a goalkeeper. Like, at this very moment, I need a goalkeeper. That was beyond unexpected. I don't know any. I mean, I can think of one goalkeeper. Or I know what rating he is. I don't know what price he'll be. As soon as you see what league I'm going to, you'll know who it is, because let's be honest, he's the best player. He's the best keeper there. Because while Julio Cesar and Casillas are still good, this guy, he has a good few years ahead of him. Casillas seems to be getting to a point where he's not that good anymore. Julio Cesar is probably not too far off that point. So, yeah. Clueless. Oh. Of course he's recently signed a new contract. Let's offer $23 million and just see. It's one option I could go for. Let's just offer for good goalkeepers. I do this after the video, but if Mandanda moves before the next match starts, actually, I wouldn't get this keeper in. So if Mandanda, actually no, he'd have to accept. We're only a few days away, hopefully. Hopefully he stays in time for us to, oh, that's the Unzam crest. Is that a different crest? I don't remember that. I really don't remember that from last FIFA. I've accepted an offer. Or I'm just, well, kinda. It's up to him where he wants to go, whether it's to Chelsea, Arsenal, or Manchester United, because now they're in the situation, and again, you'll be behind another goalkeeper, David De Gea. Okay, it looks like he's gonna stick around until the day of the... Okay, it looks like Chelsea have agreed to sign him. Just as long as the transfer doesn't go through for the next day. Don't do that. Please don't do that. Oh, thank goodness. And Arsenal have also agreed to pay the $26.1 million. Okay. So you're definitely going to London, Nyama, but you're playing one more match for us first. Don't think you're getting out of that this that easy. And in the comment section below, I'm going to need you guys to suggest goalkeepers. But first, let's play this game against Dijon, which is probably Nyama's last match.
Lille playing today against Dijon.
The home team here, I think it's a good opportunity to show the fans exactly what they're capable of. And what they are capable of is finishing in the Champions Cup spot. They've got the talent.
Lopez.
It's a team that had a wonderful campaign last season, getting promotion. This won't be easy, though. Away from home. Learn a little bit more about them, I think, at the end of the game.
This is the they all. Sebastian. I might just stick to calling Jose. It's so easier. So much easier, actually.
His great form in midfield. We'll see how a striking option works with just one up front. For the manager, instant impact. That's often the case, of course. But now it's the second competitive game.
For real.
Yeah, consistency is what any.
Lopez! Two goals in two games for Marcos Lopez.
Reacted perfectly.
He headbutts the corner flag. Zidane would be proud of you, friend. He probably hasn't got a fucking clue who you are. You know. Zidane is French. This is the French league. No, I think Lopez is Portuguese. I think so. Hang on 1 second. Just to make sure Yeah, he is. Portuguese. So yeah, it's the right Lopez, alright. I don't know why I thought his first name was Max.
Caligiuri.
I must have been thinking of somebody else.
Martin.
His first name was Maximilian.
That's a good spot by the defender. This could be a chance.
To be fair, to... No, wait. No, maybe that's who I was thinking of. Of the central player from Wolfsburg? Is he still at Wolfsburg? He is, isn't he? And I haven't used him since he was 14.
Varo. The
I know he was at Wolfsburg. Ben, no idea where he is. He could still be there. Oh, how did you miss? Sick. Yo, turn around so I can see your name so I can yell at you. The fuck?
That's a great interception.
Bro.
Could be off.
Lopez. Wait for the pass back. Heck. Jose will collect that. Yes.
He could lay it off to the supporting player.
Obadi. Obadi.
Shots on here.
Obadi!
Obadi.
Well, I don't know who the lad saw there passing the ball. Somebody in the crowd, maybe.
Tackle goes in. Lille now with the advantage given by the referee. On the attack here.
Jose. Whips in, looking for Lopez. Oh, his header's just off target.
The keeper, you know, he wasn't going
to get... Could have given him 3 goals in 2 games.
Well, I think it's one of those. He's just lost concentration. He's probably thought he's going to score before he's made connection.
You know, with my manager's bald head, it looks like I'm doing a really bad impersonation of Zinedine Zidane.
Amalfitano.
Or any bald person ever.
Caligiuri came in with the challenge and the ball broke free.
Jose, the free Obadi. Just how? How?
The team that's leading by 1 goal. And he's up for the header.
And Obadi's header is way over the bar.
Well, this attack could have been a menace to it. Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. It's a useful position, this, for the free kick.
Free kick. Lopez. Oh, completely off target. That didn't go well. To say the very least, that didn't go well.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here. It's nicely worked until that.
Looks like it's
going to
be 1-0 at half time for the second game as well. And it is. The goal came a little earlier in this game. In the 9th minute, but overall, it's not really playing out much different. Still 1-0 at half time. Still the possibility of getting that second goal at some point in the second half.
Just
by having numerous chances to score it in the first. Probably should have scored it in the first, and it was just not shooting well enough. Not finishing my chances. So, hope I'm not made to rule that mistake. Jose, whoops it in, the Preville! Oh, he took it away. I think it was going for Lopez. That's who the cross was aimed at, but the Preville was just like, nope, I'm taking this. Is he going to be a bit greedy?
Some transfer news for you to digest, Alan Smith, for all of us.
Here's the Preville. Jose. This time, the cross will find who it's looking for, and it's Turiel! Oh. It's actually the guy who missed the opportunity earlier. The guy I wanted to shout at. Number 4. Still can't see what his name is. I know it starts with an S. Here we go. Sankar. Probably saying his name wrong, but
the margin here to 2-0.
Yeah, what can you do?
Varo.
What I can do is that is a very crucial second goal.
Lille, they'll be facing Nice.
Okay, ahead to the first game of the next episode. It's going to be hectic between this and the next game because I'll be focusing on getting a goalkeeper in. I need to get one in because more than likely this is Enyema's last game for the club. He'll probably be moved. In fact, he'll probably move as soon as this match is over. He'll be either a Chelsea player or a Arsenal player.
I need to try and get the ball back now. Shots on here.
It was just off. There's a few goalkeepers in the Premier League, especially one who's already the number 2 to Courtois, Chelsea, who could be a good shout.
And in goes the cross.
Even at Arsenal, there's a too bad goalkeeping option. Who's currently the number 2 of Petr Cech, who could be a good shot as well. Or if he goes there.
Well, that's not even close.
Because Emma, in an A3 raid, is still high parade in both those keepers. Oh, just because the Chelsea keeper in question is A2. I know Arsenal's is 79, I think. I could be wrong. Maybe he's 78. Is he 79 or 78 this year?
Strong challenge. Samaritano. We've got 10 minutes left on the clock. Now he's looking for support. It's going to be a throw here.
Foul play. Of course, don't take this as a indication that I don't want to still see your suggestions in the comment section below. Please, leave any suggestion. And if I can sign them, I will. Well, I'm only going to be signing one keeper, not a whole bunch, so. Maybe it's just the same person? No? See if we can all agree on the same one? No, oh, my fucking king. I don't get comments.
Caligiuri.
Well, they gave it straight to him, didn't they?
And he could get away here.
Prevost. Can he get a second? Are you... the third. Almost completely forgot about saying Carr's goal. But, yeah. 2-0. Fantastic result. And that will be that. Good way to end off the episode on the back of 2-0 wins. Good start.
Montpellier 1. Angers 0. Nice 2.
Look at Man United. They're trying to spare pennies. Fuck you, you cunts. At least pay what Chelsea and Arsenal have already agreed to pay. And on that note, I will end this episode again. And leave in the comments, in the comment section below, what keeper should I sign? And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.